background. This idea of going abroad, for me, didn't start abroad. It started first the day I had to go to Mogoi from Helena. That is the first time as a young girl, you have to leave home and go somewhere and you start growing. Then the time I had to go to Loak. And I keep thinking, you know what we say going flying abroad is many hours. It takes me 13 hours. That is from Adelaide to Doha or Dubai, that's about 13 hours. From Dubai to Kenya, it's about 5 hours. So that's about 18. But when I was going to Loak, I would leave home in Helega Nyeri, go to Nairobi. How many hours are those? And we used to go with those Jomo Kenyatta buses, if you remember Jomo Kenyatta. So it would be like a whole day. I remember every day I would wake up and have to board Jomo Kenyatta at Karatina. Never mind the trip from Helega to Karatina, which would take another 3 hours. So by the time I'm boarding that bus in Nairobi, I've already been traveling for 8 hours. Then I board that bus at night and I get to Kisumu. That's another 12 hours because it's a whole night. So we are already at how many hours? More than 20. Then from Kisumu, I would have find my way to Bodo, which is somewhere deep in Huoland. I didn't even think the language. And when this opportunity came and people said, Australia is so far. And I asked, far from what? Far from where? Oh, it takes so many hours. Yes, in a comfortable plane with people who know what they are doing, as opposed to getting on that bus with drivers whom you don't know. So I just want to demystify the idea of studying abroad. There is no difference between working in Nairobi and you come from Helega. You still have to go back. Sometimes I come back here and my friends say, you know what? I haven't gone back home since then. Like my mother used to say, I think if she was alive today, she would still be saying, the tirohe, you know? Let's not just sit here and worry about the next governor and fight about that post. What about you think about being a governor of somewhere in the world? Let's not fight about that job and the next promotion. What about you think the whole world is available to you? Because actually, it is. So for me, today is to encourage Nyerians that let's get over and look beyond the borders. We don't have to fight about, you know, that we have to, the tirohe, that's all I can say, that we can do that and it's doable. Yes, it is scary, but I would say fear the fear and do it anyway. Because even if you don't do it, what are you going to do with our children? They are now graduated. Whether they have graduated here locally or abroad, they have done it anyway. So for me, I would encourage you to get over ourselves, fear the fear, and do it anyway. Helen is my really good friend whom I met in Australia. Despite the fact she went to uni, she was 1 year ahead of me in Nairobi University, but I didn't meet her until she came to Australia. And I was doing this job of international students before I dropped it and went back to study law. But I had a lot of students who wanted to come. And I was thinking, who can I pass on this passion to? And having known Helen, she was already also doing it, I passed all that knowledge, it's called knowledge exchange, to Helen. And that is what she does full time. She loves it, she's passionate about it. And in any case, if you have a question about anything, you can ask me and I'll refer you to Options Education Agency.